Good everyone. I am still waking up. As you can tell, you could hear my voice. It sounds like gravel. It's about 6:40 in the morning, and I am getting ready to go for a swim. I am at the Kitsilano Pool here in Vancouver. I am applying sunscreen right now, and it looks like I've probably overdone it because you can see this cast on me. Like I've applied too much, but I'm actually applying the correct amount, and I'm gonna get into that in a second. Before I get started, there's two things that I don't typically do. One is I don't apply sunscreen outside, and that's because it takes sunscreen about 15 minutes to form a film, and I want to be protected. But I have a roommate that's sleeping this morning and it's 7 a.m. so I decided not to be inconsiderate and wake them up by making a YouTube video. And the other thing is that I usually take all my clothes off before I apply the sunscreen to make sure that I get all the nooks and crannies. But we're gonna keep it PG today. So I am applying sunscreen with my swimsuit on. So you can see I was getting my face, and it's important to apply it to the places that you generally don't think about, like your lips and your ears, your toes. Where else do people forget? Ah, the eyelids. I apply it to my eyelids. But quickly, I wanted to talk about SPF because you're probably not getting as much as you think. Where is my sunscreen bottle? Right here. Okay. So to get the SPF that is listed on the bottle, you need to apply a sunscreen layer that is 2 milligrams per centimeter squared of skin. And that's not just me saying this, that is what the FDA uses when they test sunscreen for the SPF factor. For those of you guys who don't know what SPF is, it's a term that is used to indicate how effective your sunscreen is at protecting you from sunburns or UVB radiation. And SPF is a ratio that compares the smallest visible amount of detectable sunburn on protected skin or skin with sunscreen versus unprotected skin or skin without sunscreen. The SPF acts as a multiplier. So if it typically takes you about 10 minutes before you start to burn, then with an SPF of 30, you theoretically get 300 minutes or 5 hours of protection. Though in reality, you're gonna have to reapply sunscreen well before that point. So we're gonna talk more about that later. Going back to the 2 milligrams per square centimeter though, because that's what I wanna talk about right now, it made me wonder if I am applying enough sunscreen to my skin in order to be protected from the sun's harmful rays. So I decided to pop online and check out my body surface area, or BSA, using this formula, which needs my height and my weight. And it turns out if you were to roll me out like a tortilla or a yoga mat, I would be 13,800 square centimeters. And if we took 75% of that, because I'm not planning on going outside naked, hopefully, I would be 10,350 centimeters squared. If we multiply that by the 2 milligrams that the FDA recommends, I would be 0.73 ounces. And so that's how much it takes for my skin to be protected, but not everybody is a bite-sized Latina like I am. So I also decided to do the calculation for the average American male, who happens to be 5'9 and 197 pounds. And if I take 75% of that, I get 15,675 centimeters squared. And if I multiply that by the recommended 2 milligrams of sunscreen, I get 1.1 ounces. Now, the FDA has to come up with a recommendation for the general public. So they recommend 1 ounce of sunscreen for skin, and that's been simplified even further by media outlets and medical organizations to a rule of thumb that they call the shot glass rule. So I'm at a pool right now and I can't bring a shot glass on the deck because they don't want it breaking and cutting people up. But if I had a shot glass right now, I would show you the shot glass and say that you need to apply 1 shot glass worth of sunscreen to your skin. Not only is this a really convenient benchmark, but I bet you it gives the FDA an excuse to have a shot glass during work hours on their desk. In practice, most of us apply a lot less than that. We are applying 25 to 50% of the amount used in SPF testing. So we are getting an effective SPF that is less than 33% the labeled SPF. So that is a lot less. So most of us aren't getting the protection that we need. But I wanted to bounce the question back to you. What do you think? Are you using the correct amount of sunscreen? Are you not? Do you even know how much you're actually applying? I'm gonna leave the BSA, or the body surface area formula, in the description so that you can check it out and calculate your BSA for yourself. But really, we should be going through a lot of sunscreen. This 3-ounce bottle right here should be completed in a day. If you're outdoors for 6 hours, you should be able to go through this whole thing. So we're gonna talk more about that in another video, because we're gonna talk about how often the FDA wants you to reapply your sunscreen. I am gonna go for my swim. I'll see you guys later, bye.